How is it going? I hope you're doing fine. In this tutorial, we will create an abstract geometric UI design with Inkscape. Let's begin. Alright, first make sure you turn on this enable snapping. This is really helpful when you work with the grid, so just click it. And snap to the back border for making the background, so just click it. Then go to rectangle tool, click this icon. You see this tooltip, just drag it down to here. Change the color to white, this is for the background, click this. And duplicate another one for our square grid later, press Ctrl D. Then I'm pressing D to activate the dropper tool and change the color to this. Or you can input this color code to here. Then let's divide it by 6 from our pixel size. Go to here and change it to pixel. And on the width, you can do math in here, so divide it by 6. Then make it perfect square for our grid, so I'm just gonna copy this number, paste in here. Duplicate it by pressing Ctrl D, duplicate it by 3 columns and 3 rows, so I'm just pressing Ctrl D, then move it on here. And this too, press Ctrl D. And this. Make the page fit with the square. So in document properties, go to file, document properties. You can also do math in here. Input the size of the square, multiply by 3, and you get the size. Just close it. Just make this white background to fit to the page. Alright, next let's change the color. So click this, and I'm pressing D to activate the dropper tool. Change the color to this. And do the same for another one. This to this color. Now the fun thing, just play with the shape. So I'm just gonna create a circle in here. Go to your circle tool, click this, and on here, hold Ctrl Shift while scaling to make it proportional size. Then change the color to white. We're going to make a clipping mask, so I'm just gonna duplicate this square, press Ctrl D, then hold shift, then click the circle, and right click, just set clip. Make another circle in here, so with circle tool again, hold Ctrl Shift while scaling, around this, and I'm pressing D to change it the color to this, and make it align to the center of the square, so press F1, and hold shift, then click the square. And on this align distributed objects, just click this and change relative to last selected because our last selected is the square and click this icon. Then for this part, we want to divide it with Bezier tool. Press B on your keyboard to activate the Bezier tool. Then on the corner, click this and connect it to this corner. Select the line and the square. Go to path and choose division. So now you can see it's now become a slicing part. Just delete this. Then for this part, I want to create a dotted circle with circle tool again. Hold Ctrl Shift around this, just a little. Change it to white color. Press F1 and press Ctrl D to duplicate. Move it on here. Duplicate again. Select this three circle by holding Shift then click. Press Ctrl D to duplicate again. Place it on here and duplicate again. Place it on here. Just group the circle, then press Ctrl G. Make it align to the center of the square. For this, we're going to create the slice effect like this with Bezier tool again. Press B and just connect to the corner to corner and right click to release. Press F1 and hold shift and click the square. And go to path, choose the division. Alright, just throw away this part. And I'm going to duplicate this by pressing Ctrl D. Then press H to flip it horizontally. And change the color to this color. Move it to the bottom, press F1 and click this icon. And for this, I'm just gonna make inner square, press Ctrl D. And hold Ctrl Shift while scaling. And change the color to this color. Make a slicing part again in here with Bezier tool again. Press B and connect corner to corner. Then select the back of it and go to Path, choose Diffusion. Then change this color to this color. Create some circle in here. And change the color to this color. For this, with circle tool again, click this. Hold Ctrl Shift while scaling. Change it to white color. And duplicate another one, press Ctrl D. And scale it up. Run this. And we're going to make a clipping mesh, so just duplicate the square, press Ctrl D, click the circle, right click, choose set clip. For these two, make a clipping mesh, press Ctrl D, and click this, right click, choose set clip. And let's change the color to this color. If you can see the white circle, it's because it's in the back, so just send it to back. And for the last, make it slice again with bezier tool again, connect to corner. Then select these two and go to Path, choose the diffusion. And just delete this. Add some circle in here. Next, let's bring the pattern in here, so I'm just going to duplicate this by pressing Ctrl D and move it on here. Then go to this edit objects, go to the pattern, and change the pattern to wavy. I want to change this pattern to this blue color. So right now you cannot change the color. If you change the color, it's become the plain solid color. So if you want to change the pattern to this blue, you have to go to the object, pattern, and pattern to object. Change the color to this color. Make it become pattern again by going to object, pattern, object to pattern. Or you can see my previous video about how to work with the pattern, its full explanation and with the sample. So because this is in pattern right now, so just gonna scale it by pressing Ctrl Shift and press F2. You see this handle, just drag to here. Like this, alright, and you can drag to here too. Okay, then make it clip with the shape, just move it to here. Make sure the triangle in the front, so just move the wavy line to the bottom, like this. Then select these two and right click, choose set clip. I love that one. Add more in here. So I'm just gonna duplicate this square, press Ctrl D and move it on here. And go to pattern again, click this and change it to the polka dots medium. Because this is a pattern, you must edit the actual objects by going to object, pattern, choose pattern to object. And now it's become the object. So I'm just gonna make it fast by going to group it and make a clipping mask later, press Ctrl G to group and change the color to this red. Make it in the middle of the square by selecting this and this square and go to this align distribute objects, make it last selected and click this icon. Alright, do you remember how to select the bottom object? Just by holding Alt then click again, and now you see it's now selected the polka dots. Bring it to the front, click this. Just make one step down below the circle. Make a clipping mask by clicking the yellow square by pressing Alt click. Then press Ctrl D to duplicate and select this polka dot. Right click, choose set clip. And for the last, we're going to create the heading and the web menu. So go to this text tool and type and change the font to this and scale it up. Reduce the spacing by pressing T and select all and go to this option, just reduce it and change the color to this. Let's create a sample lorem ipsum text by going to extension, text, and choose the lorem ipsum. Let's reduce the number of paragraphs and the sentence paragraph by 2. Then apply and close. Bring up the text to here. Just gonna delete some and change it to the Roboto. Make a like one. Get it down by pressing Ctrl Shift. Place it on here. Change the color to this color. You can bring the ruler, so just drag this to here. And just make it neat. For the button, with rectangle tool, click this. And on here, just drag it like this. You can round the corner by dragging this. Change the color to this color. Let's type make it same size as the paragraphs. Can copy the size to here. Scale this down too. Align it to the center. For the menu, so just make a ruler in here and type change it to and press Ctrl D to duplicate. Duplicate again. Change the color to this color. Create a rectangle to make it as active menu. Click this. And just make it a flat rectangle. Change the color to this color. Duplicate this by pressing Ctrl D. Then click this. Just drag it to the edge of the page. On this. And change the color to this color. And press F1, then send it to the lower back. You can hide the guides by going to View and click this guides to turn off, or by pressing Shift and straight line on the keyboard in the backslash. For the bottom, I'm just gonna duplicate this. Press Ctrl D and place it on here. Change it to with the rectangle tool, click this, make it around this, just make it to the corner, and change the color to this color. Then press F1, send it to the back. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Quick explore the geometric pattern and just play with the shape. I'm Zeki from Zeki Design. Create something good today. Thanks for watching.